What up, y'all? Planet of Fakes here, your captain. Should be a good ride today. This show is executive produced by me and also produced by Miss Don Diva. Watch that first step. It's going to be a doozy. This should be a good, smooth flight, though. Just give me time to take care of the cockpit. I'm gonna play an oldie but goodie. I hope you enjoy it. I'm rocking with the best, the real to the seventh power.
Chicago,
it is
DJ
Rosé.
Bitch, I'm a boss to you, bitch. I'm a motherfucking boss, man. You already know what the fuck going on, man. Call me Ross to you, bitch. Whoa. Call me motherfucking Ross. You know? Motherfuckers know what the fuck going on, man.
It's Major on a track.
Bitch, I'm a boss to you, bitch. Call me Rick Ross to you, bitch. I can't trick off with you, bitch. I just be dogging you, bitches.
I feel like the Pistons.
I'm up in the kitchen. I just be whipping it.
Up inside the hype dancing.
Bitch, I'm a boss to you, bitch. Boss to you, bitch.
Bitch, I'm a boss to you, bitch. Boss to you, bitch.
I feel like the Pistons. I'm up in the kitchen. I just be whipping it. Up and shot like he missing. Better not lack in the go. Better not lack for a hoe. I can keep tracking a hoe. I just be spending my dough. Ain't shit for the low. That was a minute ago. I'm not no kin of that hoe. I just went in on that hoe. I'm about to surf up. These niggas, they all on my nuts. I don't give a fuck. He make one fuck move.
I grabbed all the fuck.
They know I go nuts. Whoa. I get it popping like Crush. Whoa. I got a drilling and rush.
No. I pop a pill and go nuts.
They saying what's up. They know I'm finna blow up. I hit the surf and I duck.
Look.
She gave me head and she dug.
What up, King Jim?
We kill it.
It's your show, Miss Andiva.
Roll up some weed in a Dutch. Bitch, I get high and go up. Oh, bitch,
that
I get
like
high
button.
And she stuck. Bitch, I'm a boss to you, bitch. Call me Rick Ross to you, bitch. I can't trick off with you, bitches. I just be dogging you, bitches.
I feel like the Pistons.
I'm up in the kitchen.
Woke
I just be whipping. Up in Chirac, we be dancing. Bitch, I'm
belly
a boss to you, bitch. Boss to you, boss to you, bitch.
Bitch, I'm a boss to you, bitch. Boss to you, bitch.
I ball like the Pistons. I'm up in the kitchen. I just be whipping. Up in Chirac, we be dancing.
I just be whipping. Fuck a little bitch, she be tripping. On the block, my nigga, smoke outside of the swish.
Big backwoods, whoa.
Got caught with a pistol, niggas telling that yeah, get you. Couple my niggas paid up and came and get
you.
Locked up, I ain't thinking about no bitch. Trick.
Fuck that shit, money.
Same day, I was on the block getting it.
I'm getting this money.
My mama told me I can't trust these niggas.
Fuck them niggas.
My daddy, he tell me don't trust these bitches.
Why you been
in and out? Remember days had no licks.
I was broke,
no mask on. 30 out trying to get it.
God dang.
Couple niggas they telling Jeff for change.
Pouring them out
in a rack. I pray for this change.
We finna start the fuck up.
Bitch, I'm a boss to you, bitches. Call me Rick Ross to you, bitches. I can't trick off with you, bitches. I just be dogging you, bitches.
I ball like the Pistons.
I'm up in the kitchen. I just be whipping. Up in Chirac, we be dancing. Bitch, I'm a boss to you, bitch. Boss to you, boss to you, bitch.
Bitch, I'm a boss to you, bitch. Boss to you, bitch.
I ball like the Pistons. I'm up in the kitchen.
I'm so glad you returned. I'm always happy to see you.
I just be whipping. Up in Chirac, we be dancing.
That is in the mix.
I got two chats ready. We doing it. Yo, before we start this, let's hear my other song, man. Let's hear We Winning, because we winning, y'all. You know how I know we winning? Because we still positive, we still productive, we still prolific, y'all. Look at everybody else. And no shots at them. Good luck to them, man, for real. When you a good person, man, you don't mind disassociations, yo. You understand? People on YouTube didn't make me, man. I was made before I came to YouTube. And with that being said, let's get into this next song before we start this, man. Shout out to the chat, King Ben, Miss Don Diva, Queen Jilda. You know, it's always pleasant.
Hey, shut up, bro. What up, yo? That's you dropping all these videos like that?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Well, go on here and hit their ass with another one, man.
DJ Rose.
Damn, son, where'd you find this?
The Chicago nigga.
I'm so used to winning.
We the Wokavillians, ninjas.
Hey, yo, KD. Get money.
Give yourselves a pat on the back,
stay
man.
Stay focused.
Y'all on the winning team. Y'all gonna have a winning team, man.
Ain't no stopping. We gonna
put
keep going.
Your destiny we over take friends, fight. Man. Cause ain't no friends in retirement.
Let's get it.
Hey, y'all share this in the group. I'm going to take care of the pages and YouTube.
Hey, DJ Rose. Motherfuckers better catch this wave.
Rockin'.
Or get left.
We winning.
We winning. We winning. More money, more problems, baby. We constantly spending. Hell no, ain't bout drama, baby. They won't know our business. I'm trying to stack all this money, baby. Move us out the city.
Let's get it.
We winning.
We winning.
We
winning.
We
winning.
More money, more problems, baby. We constantly spending. Hell no, ain't about drumming, baby. They won't know our business. I'm trying to stack all this money, baby. Move us out the city. We winning. We winning. It's just the beginning, baby. They hate it on Jesus. So fuck all the haters, baby. They hate that we get it. Take you out to Red Lobster, baby. To show them we eat it.
Okay.
I got the kids do my dance. They love me, they telling a friend.
And what else?
How could you not wanna dance? I'm surfing, created a trend. My wallet hang off of my pants. Watch it take off once again.
Come on.
We winning.
More money, more problems. Baby, like I'm constantly spending.
Hell no, ain't about drama, baby. They won't
ain't
know
about drama, y'all. We ain't the drama
all this
community,
money,
bro.
Baby, move us out
you prepared for it, but we not with it, man. Go ahead and that shit to your fucking
more money, more
trying to uplift
baby,
my
we constantly spending. Hell no, ain't about drumming, baby. They won't know our business. I'm trying to stack all this money, baby. Move us out the city.
Planet Effect, shout out to the chat. Queen Jilda in the house. I gotta make sure this is a special show just for the queen. Get into this, man. This is a story. I don't know nothing about it. Miss Don Diva had this prepared for us for a while now. I'm finally able to get to it, thankfully, and we're gonna sit back and enjoy it. And these, you see this young man right here? I do what I do every day with the people that help me to try to prevent it. You understand? Hopefully, like, you know, somebody will see our videos, our posts, our whatever, and it may deter them from doing something bad. You understand? They may see a story of somebody that did something they were thinking about doing, and it changed their impact. You understand? And just based on that, every day we do good, whether we see views or not, because it only takes that one person to see something to change their mind from doing something bad to not doing something bad. So definitely give yourselves a pat on the back for that, because I know personally what I've done has done that. I got kids on my pages that probably been on my pages since they were 16. They like 22 now, and they thank me every day. You know what I mean? That's what keeps me humble. That's what keeps me positive. And most of all, that's what keeps me grounded. And I'm not going to let anybody ever come in between doing that for people, because that's more important than fake-ass friendships and starting beef from chat rooms. You understand? That's kiddie shit. People are grown-ass adults. They should be doing grown-ass adult things on here, because they will get grown-ass results instead of, you know, the opposite. But we're not knocking nobody. You here to have fun, have fun, man. But if it's at the cost of others, just be careful, because the same thing you do to people, people do to you. And with that being said, we're going to have to get into this. Y'all know how we start these shows. I'm rocking with the Real to the 7 Power Best. And I'm nothing without the real people behind me, besides me. And I'm proud of y'all. Straight up. I'm so proud of the people with me. And that's why I carry myself the way I carry myself. Because it's not only for me, but it's also for the people behind me, man. All the people in the groups, the pages, everything, man. Carry myself the way I carry myself for y'all. You gotta realize some people just don't expect black people to be successful. We gonna surprise they fucking asses.
Here we came too far in the darkest days. Don't know where we are, but who we are. Here we came too far in the darkest days. Don't know where we are, but who we are. Here we came too far. In the darkest days, don't know where we are, but who we are. Yeah, we came too far. In the darkest days, don't know where we are, but who we are. You overdosing on the same damn pill, trying to but can't get no deal. Struggling just to pay one bill, wishing you had a uncle Phil. Rob him if you got a kill. Make sure he don't get up those hills. Time for me to get on one more drill. Won't stop till we hit 1 mil, bitch. You know I'm talking, so move the ass and stop watching. This your new job, so clocking. I'm a boss, no matter if I'm barking. I come straight from road Boston. It's the same old road I be crossing. It's the same strip I'm always walking. Don't run up, might end up in a coffin. You will never catch me lacking. Me and my niggas stay packing. Uptown the shit that I'm repping. So I warn you, just use that caution. Niggas see me in my foreign. That bitch is up and she boring. Most these girls now just toxin. And I hate to say it, but they coming. Niggas have no better. In their pocket, but be the ones back in office. Y'all see design, I be rocking. Of course, y'all on IG talking. I'm the last one that's laughing. While y'all niggas is chatting, y'all talking about this blasting. But we know y'all niggas is acting. Yeah, we came too far.
Come on, came too far to let suckers take us down, baby.
Where we are, but who we are.
Come on, come on.
We came too far. In the darkest days, don't know where we are, but who we are. In the darkest days, don't know where we are, but who we are. Yeah, we came too far. In the darkest days, don't know where we are, but who we are. Times dealing with the
same old shit. Pass it if I need one more hit. Still driving with no permit. Ain't drunk, but I'm trying to get lit. She told me that I could hit. Told her I ain't trying to come in. She took out but her tits. Need bread, don't need that.
Nice work to the mama.
Time to go focus on commas. George be one about drama. Yeah, I'ma holler. Pull up on court with a bomber. Ball, how the fuck that I wanna? You know that I gotta make it for all my fucking brothers. Pull the shit up, blow up my head straight to the Bahamas. Don't jack down, I'm a scammer. Coming up the whole lot of hanging on like a hanger. Trying to see all the ops dead. Smelly wood always in my head. Seeing city make it spread. Yeah, I heard what the fuck I said. All my niggas full and fair. That's what's my dead. I'm just trying to be ahead. Make it back home in the bed. Shot out Gene and Red. Niggas be taking off heads. I'm just trying to get this bread left out.
Yeah, we came too far. In the darkest days, don't know where we are, or who we are. Yeah, we came too far. In the darkest days, don't know where we are, or who we are. Yeah, we came too far. In the darkest days, don't know where we are, or who we are. Yeah, we came too far. In the darkest days, don't know where we are, or who we are. Who we are.
All right, so this is the first article I'm pulling up right now. Yeah, this is all Ms. Don Diva's work. You know, y'all know she got the, please, man, Ms. Don Diva keeps me grounded to the current events. I'm so behind right now, I even got to catch up with Prissy B. Oh, my gosh. Prissy B shared an article in the group yesterday. I think dude is like 86 years old. His job had to let him go. He was obsessed with Tupac. You got to shout out to Prissy B. So shout out to Prissy B, man. Shout out to you too, King Ben. You know I uploaded that girl fight as Kokia fight. Not as her fight, but I asked people, is this Kokia getting beat up? The only reason I did it, because I did it live and the people in the chat is like, yo, you should upload this fight. So I put it on the website. Yeah, make sure y'all sign up for the website. In 2020, that's going to be the place to be, man. Hell yeah. Mad shout outs to Prissy B. So we're about to get into it. I am going to have to, I guess, refresh it. But this story right here is crazy, y'all. I don't even want to ruin it. I don't even want to ruin it, but I do want to just get to the young people and let them know this ain't the move, man. Damn. Nah, don't worry about it. We're going to have to make do. Let me just see what I can do. So shocked people don't want to learn this. This is going to be people bread and butter in the future. Let's do it. Look at that title, man. Cleveland teen held on charges of killing grandmother, stabbing siblings and cousins. Ms. Don Diva, y'all. So my scroll button, man. I'm trying to see all the ops dead. Come on, scroll button. What's up, baby? My scroll button acting up, y'all. Let's try this again. I'm trying to see all the ops dead. My bad. Scroll button acting up. What the hell? Scroll button acting up. What the hell? Scroll button acting up. What the hell? But, you know, we fight computers here and I just beat their ass. Let's get into this Planet of Fakes, man, for kids. Okay, come on, baby. Come on, baby. Since the news article one's acting up, we're just going to look at it straight in the courthouse. I know how I do. Let's go straight to the courthouse. Because that Fox website want to act stink. So you act this thick. Look at the program. Where my mouse at, man? Where my unmute at, dog? What is going on? All right, here we go. What was that, 39 seconds? Give me a second. This program acted silly. Maybe I missed an update on this program or something. This joint acting up. I'm going to let it play. I'm going to play the audio from the computer. Feezy. Baby, is on? Nah, that shit ain't on. Merge, just give me a second. I'm turning on this freaking sleeping speaker. Stupidest speaker of all time. I got another one. I just bought another one. Let me try to plug this joint in. Yep, I bought another speaker. And that joint was giving me problems too, man. Sound, y'all. Yeah, this video might not even have sound. I don't hear no sound coming from that shit. Let me try this next one. Yep, I don't hear no sound from that shit. This is legit. This is, I don't even know how to turn this down. This is Jalen Latrell Plummer.
As a kid growing up, my dream was to go to college, play baseball, and get a degree. Coming out of high school, I had two choices. I was accepted into a four-year university, but I decided to come to Tri-C after receiving a scholarship. I got my associate's degree at Tri-C. They transferred all my credits straight into Baldwin Wallace, so I started at Baldwin Wallace University as a junior. My name is Tyler Leonard, and I earned my first degree at Tri-C.
I can hear the sound. My fucking speaker's still acting stupid. I don't know what the hell's going on with the sound. Let me check again, y'all. I even played it from the website of the Fox website, but we just had sound from the YouTube. Remember, I was just playing We Winning and all that shit. So I don't know what happened to the sound. Y'all can still hear me though, right? Let me test the sound again. We just had sound. I don't know where the sound went. Yeah, you can hear me, but we can't hear the video. I played it not only on the program, but I played it on the computer. It's acting up. I'm about to test the YouTube. Before the New Year's, I'm gonna definitely get new computers. Definitely. It's just, I like building my own computers, so if I don't got time to build it, I gotta wait for time to build it before I purchase. Yep, still here, just waiting for Chrome. Bear with us. This is the court case of JaVel, I believe. What's been going on with y'all, though? Any other stories that I should know about? Put it in the chat. Let me know. We can talk about it while we wait for the computer to get fixed. I was amazed at the 86-year-old man that got fired for Tupac. Yes, I'll try closing Chrome and reopening it. I'm not into the Kokia bashing, all right? We already know that what type of person she is. So, you know, after knowing what type of person she is, to continue following her and doing all of that is just like, you know what I mean? It's harassment now. That nail lady, Word. Yo, that nail lady, she got her own YouTube channel with the video. This is when Kokia Jackson threatened me. Bianca Adventures is the name. She's a trip. She's a trip. Yeah, hell yeah, he got fired for that. Turn this chrome off. Turn that chrome off. Let me test one of these Google photos. And this way I know if it's the sound of the program. If I have to restart, I restart. I'm gonna start being live on YouTube and Facebook at the same time. I did it the other night. I hear that? I don't hear it. My speaker might be off though. Let me check. Alright, so the sound worked. Let's see if I can get this video going. See, this shit don't got no sound. Yeah, this shit don't got no sound, yo. Why would they upload this shit with no sound? Look at that shit, no sound. Shit ain't got no sound. Yeah. This shit ain't got no sound, y'all. I'm open Chrome again. Let's see. Yo, this joint ain't got no sound. Because y'all can hear me. I press play. I muted it. And it still ain't got no sound. I'm over here a little chaffed up trying to get this started, though. Like, this look like a good story. They got mittens on them. I never seen a prisoner brought into court in mittens. They got mittens on them, man. I'm tired of them making us look like savages. Everywhere I look, they try to make us look so uncivilized, man. That's why it's so important to just be a positive role model. We not perfect, but at the end of the day, we not doing the worst we could be doing. So that's why I appreciate it. Just being able to wake up every day and do it, man. And be rewarded for it. Yeah, y'all can hear me though, but y'all can't hear the sound. Yeah, there's no sound on this video. Yep, they uploaded the court shit with no sound, but I'm gonna open it in Google. Let's see if it got sound in Google, but I doubt it because I played it in Google and it had no sound there. Yep, I put that fight you put in the group King Ben right on the website. People visited too. Is this Kokia? No, it damn well is not, but everybody on the live is saying, yo, you should upload that. Word up. Shout out to King Ben, man. King Ben be knowing he's a perfect poster, man. He be hitting y'all with those stories, man. And a lot of times I don't be leaving y'all names out. It just sometimes it takes me so long to make the video, I be forgetting who I got it from. Yup. And it'll take too long to find out. So I just start putting Planet of the Fake groups now so they'll know it's the whole group. Yup. I got it on Chrome. It don't got no sound. Let's see if we can pull on the closed caption. All right, let's see if we can put on the closed caption. We gonna be some reading marks tonight. Damn, I thought they had the closed caption right here. Damn, they moved the closed caption with the feezy. Scroll for details. Yo, what they did with the closed caption? Oh, it probably don't have it on here. There probably is no closed caption. Yeah, there is no closed caption. How they have it silent with no closed? You know what? He might be a minor. So that's why they not, I don't know. I'm not trying to even figure it out, y'all. I can't figure it out. Let's try the Fox News story again. Yeah, let's just try the Fox News story. I'm not even trying to figure out why they uploaded the court proceeding with no sound. Yeah. It's not unordinary. You know that as long as they give us a picture, it beats no picture. So let's do it right here. I got the Fox open. Let's see if we can play it. If it plays with no problem, I'll bring it to the program. I'm dying to hear about the story now. Cleveland, Ohio, 18-year-old Jalen Latrell Plummer entered a not guilty plea in his first court appearance Monday in the death of Diane Madison. Plummer is Diane Madison's grandson and is also the brother of two of the children who were stabbed. The other child who was stabbed is Plummer's cousin. Police say Plummer started stabbing the three children in their sleep around 12:15 a.m. Saturday in a home on Chickasaw Ave. 67-year-old Diane Madison was killed. The children ages 10 and 12 are being treated at Rainbow's Babies and Children's Hospital. Police say officers found Plummer in the shower at the home. He was treated for his cuts to his hand in court. Monday, his hands were still bandaged. So those weren't mittens. His hands was actually bandaged. I don't know if people know about fighting with knives. When you fight with knives, it's typical to stab yourself and slice yourself, y'all. Two of the children were able to run for help during the attack. Plummer will be held on $2 million bond. His preliminary hearing is scheduled for July 8th, which already passed. Madison is the mother of the serial killer Michael Madison. Let me go back up. Oh shit, his grandmother is the mother of a serial killer. He's the grandson of a mother of a serial killer. And that's why it's not good, man. That's why we gotta keep the news and bad news and stuff like that away from the young people, man. Cause when they get a hold of what, you know, their relatives or older relatives are capable of or have done, it'll start to manifest in them. Like, am I that? Am I what my uncle is? Am I what my cousin is? Let me give you a perfect example. Don't you know that children of people that use drugs, in their mind as a child, they grow up wondering, is that their future? You understand? Or children to a parents that drink, the children will be more prone to drink because guess what? they always saw their parents drunk. And then once they take a drink and they feel how it make it feel, now they know why their parents got drunk and they begin to drink. No difference here. Maybe all the whisper and chatter got to the young man and he found out what his uncle did, and maybe his uncle was cool with him and he believed he had that in him, and with all the violence that they're portraying on TVs today, it's all looking like it should be done. And the reason they make murder and all this crime look acceptable is because they get paid off the private foreign prisons that are here. Didn't you know somebody just shared a post in the group that, hey, the private prisons are suing the state for not occupying the jails? And the reason they could do that, again, because the states are foreign companies. They're in contracts with other foreign companies known as the prison. The prison has a contract with America, but there are no longer any Americans here. It's just U.S. citizens. And based on being U.S. corporate citizens, you now can go to jail for U.S. corporate laws. There are no lawful laws in the United States company. Companies can't make lawful laws. They're actually enforcing their laws by the barrel of a gun and the ignorance of the people. But at the end of the day, people got to raise their children in this. Raise them wisely and let them know what states are. Because right now, people are bugging the fuck out and they don't even know what they're living in. Let me see. I got a video here. Let me play. Oh, here we go. We got sound, baby. Let's do it.
Adrian, good morning.
Uh-oh, we got sound. We starting this live, man. I got tired of reading it anyway. Yo, check this out, y'all. This is a sad story, man, and this is why I do it every day, man, because trust me, man, a lot of young people thank me for all we do, and that's why I always thank y'all, and I stay humble to y'all, and I stay loyal to y'all, you know what I'm saying? Because a lot of people do come thank me for everything we do. Don't think we go unacknowledged. You understand? We are very acknowledged. We got multiple channels with more subs than people with hundreds of people in their chats with one channel, so don't ever, you know, think that we're not where we're supposed to be. We're exactly where we're supposed to be. We're doing millions of views each month per channel. We're exactly where we're supposed to be. Our website, I can't even count the stats. We're exactly where we want to be. My big channel's on Facebook, hidden until we found all the traitors. You understand? We good, man. We perfect. I hope the people that's hating or, you know, busy doing whatever, I hope one day they do get their stuff together and be as big as us. They'll see how hard I work, and maybe they'll respect us for that. And they'll see how hard y'all work, and maybe they'll respect y'all for that. But if they never do accomplish anything in life, we shouldn't be expecting them to respect us for accomplishing things, all right? But with that being said, let's get into this news story right here. This joint is crazy. This is crazy. I got to shout out to Miss Dawn Diva. Like, I want her to take over. Her and Keejan ain't no joke. Shout out to Keejan. She probably fell asleep. She works so hard. She's getting nice with the graphics. I love seeing Keejan's Instagram, man. She came so far. Yep, all of y'all came so far. I'm proud of everybody. Be proud of yourselves. Here we go. I don't got the scroll button. Yes, I do. Come on, let's run. Rush, 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 rush. We here. Ah, made it. Ah, here we go. Shout out to the Reels of the Seven Power Best. Here go the story, man, of Latrell. Do the other one start? Let's see. I'm going to start it from the top. I'm rocking with the best, man. Reels of the Seven Power, playing in the fakes. Well, Covellian's in here, man. This is very sad. I mean, Covellian's in here. Day One's in here. And soon I'ma unblock everybody. Soon I'ma unblock everybody. Cause I got a surprise. It's gonna probably come around September, around Kanika's birthday. For Kanika's birthday, everybody's gonna be unblocked. Yo, you see this shit ain't even starting. While we wait for it, I'm gonna play something on the computer. Fuck that. While we wait for this motherfucker, let's listen.
It may appear as early as today. Adrian, good morning.
Christy Todd, good morning. This is just tragic and puzzling all at the same time. The three children, ages 10 and 12, stabbed multiple times. Police thankfully say that they are going to recover from their injuries. Just after midnight Saturday, police were called to Chickasaw Avenue on the east side of Cleveland, where they found 61-year-old Diane Madison stabbed to death. They say her three grandchildren were also stabbed and taken to the hospital. Police found the suspect, 18-year-old Jalen Plummer, still inside the home and hiding in the family shower. Investigators say he went into the children's bedrooms while they were sleeping and attacked them. Two of the kids ran to a neighbor's home. The third was able to hide. The Fox 8 I team has learned the victim, Diane Madison, is the mother of convicted serial killer Michael Madison. You may remember Madison is in prison for murdering three women. In 2013, their bodies were found near his home in East Cleveland. One of the wounded 10-year-old girls is his daughter, we are told. Neighbors were just shocked at hearing this news of this crime.
Our neighbors are good around here. You know, we're trying to maintain our lives.
Let me see.
I think it's a pretty good neighborhood. You got your little things, but it's everywhere, right?
Now, at this point, investigators have not given us any indication of a motive for this crime or if this suspect, an 18-year-old, has any kind of personal connection to the family. Again, we expect him to be in court.
Oh, so he didn't stab his own grandmother. His hands is like that, Ms. Dawn Diva, because he cut himself from stabbing people. Yep, I was telling
you. It was awful. I don't want anybody to go through this.
Ted and Fran Ganda lost a lot of their...
Yo, his hands are like that, Ms. Dawn Diva, because you may not know. When you dealing with a knife and stabbing somebody, you tend to cut yourself. So he was stabbing people so much with both hands, he cut himself. Yep. When you stabbing people, you cut yourself. Because the knife bends on bone and shit like that. It should slice your hands up. And that's why he got those mittens on. I thought those are actually bandages from cutting himself. Let's see if we can find them on YouTube again. So he's just a teenager. And maybe he could be the child of one of the victims and came there to get revenge. That's what it sounds like, y'all. He didn't kill his grandmother. He killed a grandmother. He may be a child of Michael Madison's victims. Let us look at Michael Madison. I'm going to try to show you the story of Jalen, though. But Jalen is not related to them. So I'm telling you, I think it's a revenge case. They're rocking with the Real to the Seventh Power Best. If I'm not, go find the sixth and the eighth. Don't trust anybody that never went live with something positive. I think I found it. Let's see.
I used to manage my team with spreadsheets. It was a nightmare. Monday.com is a platform to track everything your team is working on. We use it for all our projects, marketing.
Here goes his arraignment, yo.
Plummer will enter a not guilty plea and demand a preliminary hearing. Okay. He has lower scores on the risk assessment.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning, how are you?
Good.
Yeah, revenge killing.
$2 million.
Gosh, oh my.
Contact order. Apparently, Mr. Plummer is unable to sign because of the condition of his hands. But me saying it is just as good as him signing the form And it's a $2 million bond anyway.
Is that true?
It's like, yeah, you can make the cash assured.
Thank you.
All right. And I'll put no contact.
See, he couldn't even sign the agreement, y'all. He couldn't even sign the agreement. Let's see if I can find another one. I got another one here. It's a little bit longer.
A man charged in the murder of his grandmother went before a judge this morning.
Oh, it was his grandmother.
General Latrell Plummer is charged with stabbing 62-year-old Diane Madison on Saturday. She is the mother of serial killer Michael Madison. Three children in the home were also stabbed. They include Plummer's 10 and 12-year-old siblings and 10-year-old cousin. Plummer is being held on $2 million bond.
All right, so we got that. We got Plummer. They don't got much on him yet, right? Oh, woman dead, three injured. I got the initial news story. Let's do it. Oh, they also got the bail, the bond denied. So let's check that out too. I rock with the Real to the Seven Power Best, man. Planet of Fakes, Team No Friends.
Breaking overnight. Cleveland police detectives are investigating after a 60-year-old woman was stabbed to death at a home on the city's east side. Two 10-year-old girls and a 12-year-old boy were taken to the hospital with stab wounds. Police say an 18-year-old male suspect was also taken to the hospital with cuts on his hands. This happened just after midnight at a home on Chickasha Avenue. We will bring you the latest details on this developing story as soon as we get them.
Listen up, the soap you shower with, you probably haven't even questioned what bar of soap you lather up with. Let's face it, most guys don't. They're still using whatever bar their mommy bought for her little man.
Such a dumbass soap.
It's in the cold-blooded murder that shocked a small community in Wilcox County.
Yeah, that's right. The two teens charged with the crime facing a judge for the first time just hours ago.
17-year-old Maurice Powell and 18-year-old Marlon Mindenhall are charged with capital murder and the death of 20-year-old Tim Fletcher of Pine Hill.
Our Steve Alexander was in the courtroom for that hearing. He now joins us live from Camden in Wilcox County. Steve?
And there was something kind of unusual that happened in that hearing, and I'll tell you about that in just a moment. Powell and Mindenhall are both charged with capital murder, and today the district attorney's office said why capital murder. There was a mitigating factor in the murder, shooting from inside of a vehicle. Now, first, we're going to show you the two, Powell and Mindenhall, being led from the courtroom to jail, and Powell was asked a question.
Did you guys kill anyone?
Come on. Go. Walk. Go.
Both Maurice Powell and Marlon Mindenhall had attorneys appointed for them today, so no pleas were entered. Both were ordered held on no bond, and authorities say both were already out on bond on other cases when Fletcher was shot and killed. So the DA's office.
See, what people don't understand is, as us, as the adults now and of the future, we got to start doing so good that it's really no excuse for people to be doing bad. You know what I mean? And I'm not saying us as a race or whatever, we're doing bad now, but we got to be doing so good that we automatically know when people do silly crimes like this, it's just because there's something wrong with them, not because they was like economically challenged or oppressed. You understand? That's why I work so hard every day, because, you know, if I could do it, it's showing somebody out there with nothing to do that it's possible, man. And that's why, you know, you got to kind of try to get the people that's doing nothing every day to get in the habit of doing something that's going to pay off for them one day, or something they could pass on to the youth and the youth get paid off of it. That's the thing I never understand about a lot of people. If you want YouTube and you don't want the money, why not help somebody that may need the money get the money? That's why I never understood people. You know what I mean? That's why I always try to help people get monetized by telling them how to get monetized, not following in my footsteps, because my footsteps is different. I got 9-10 channels. I done been terminated 30-something times, and I'm still ahead of the people with hundreds of people in their chat. See, a fool would think because we got 4 people in here, we're not popular. But a wise man to know, if he got more subscribers than all the people with 120 people in the chat, those 120 people in the chat, they must not be real supporters. Because I only got 4 people and more views than all of them. Is it possible my 4 people could be contributing and sharing more than 120 or 200 people in chats? Perhaps. Because think about it, if I'm one man that's not popular and we're just so successful on these platforms, they're either one man or one woman with more popularity than me, longer. Where should they be if it's real support? We should be able to go on Facebook. If we got 100,000 likes or followers on Facebook, since they got 200, 300 people in their chat, I even seen people with 1,000 people in their chat from the KJ universe. We should be able to go on Facebook and see their pages and stuff with millions. We don't. What does that tell you? All they got is the chats. All they got is the chats. And that's even for the people in the chats. And there's nothing wrong with that. But if you let the chats stagnate you, or you as a content creator stagnate in your chat, whatever good or positivity is going to really come from that? Word, we just watch, you know, a negative forces succeed. You know what I mean? We're a good force, but we're not the good force people used to seeing, so they don't gravitate to us, and that's good. We don't want to be somebody. We want to be nobody. You know what they used to call my crew back in the days? They used to call us the Ghost Hustlers. Yep, you know, like Ghostbusters? But instead of busters, it was hustlers. They used to call us the Ghost Hustlers, and the reason they called us the Ghost Hustlers is because we just get our money and go. Nobody would ever see us, but we'll be there. You understand? So they called us the Ghost Hustlers because we just got our money and went. Like, word, blase, blah, was over here. Yeah, I didn't see him. Like, yeah, Ghost Hustlers. They'll never see us. Like, we just do it. Like, damn, he came already? Like, yeah, I didn't see him. Ghost Hustlers. Yep, Ghost Hustlers. People done named sports teams after me and shit like that, and then got the nerve to make videos talking about they only know me from smoking. But yeah, they call us the Ghost Hustlers. I do it here too. Don't y'all notice? Y'all don't see me. Don't y'all notice I made thousands of dollars and got thousands of subscribers, and y'all don't even see me. You understand? Like, Ghost Hustling. And I don't mind if you see me, if you saw me or whatever the case may be, but I'm just making my point. People just spent 2 years seeing people, being lied to, being disrespected, being betrayed. And you see these people. You're getting betrayed by people that's showing you. You're seeing their eyes. You're seeing their body language. Suckers. Me, y'all don't see me. I don't come here and scam. You're not going to hear no type of fucking controversial stories about me. None of that shit. You're not going to hear me inboxing people to donate to me. Nope, none of that shit. That's why I could go to sleep and I wake up with good karma. Because I don't do shit to people. I'm used to people falling out just because, you know, when you're not used to succeeding, when you're around people that's succeeding and shit like that, it's pressure. And it's not always fun. I had my fun as a youth, but I still have fun now. You understand? Helping people not do bad is fun to me. And you know how you help them not do bad? You help them do for themselves. You help them be able to create something to teach the youth. You know? We can't teach trolling to the youth. We can't teach harassment of people to the youth. We can't teach doxing to the youth. They're not as strong as we are, y'all. The youth is not as strong as we are. So if they see us doing things that only strong people could do and they start doing it to each other, we're going to start losing the youth. And we can't afford to lose any more youth. You know? That's why we got to do things that will inspire them to either copy us while doing good things or do better things. You know what I mean? Right now, we got a population of youth trying to do worse things because they've been under the impression that bad is good and good is bad. But let's get into this.
Has also made a motion to revoke those bonds, too. Now, while the judge was explaining to Powell his rights, Powell started talking, and he said what sounded like, "We drove through a roadblock three times." The judge asked him to stop talking. Now, first we're going to hear from the DA about that, and then a pastor who's a friend of the family.
He said he drove through a roadblock three times, and the officer saw him. And that's when the judge was trying to stop him from talking. But for obvious reasons, why? He presumed innocent until proven guilty, but he acknowledged, and basically with that statement, that he was there.
Still not heard of any motive or any connection between?
No, I mean, we all hear the same rumors. The family hears the same rumors that everybody hears, but there's been no official word on any kind of motive right now. It just seems like he was in the wrong place at the wrong time, and it seems just a senseless random act is all.
Now, Fletcher's parents and family were in court today, as were family members and friends of the suspects, but no one talked to reporters from that group. A preliminary hearing for both suspects is now set on August 12th. Now, as you can gather, still a lot of unanswered questions about the case. The DA says a motive is still under investigation, and the sheriff has said there possibly could be another suspect, possibly a juvenile in the case. The sheriff did not talk today. Aaliyah, the state law enforcement agency, now is investigating the case. It's the lead investigative agency. Reporting live from Camden, Steve Alexander, Fox 10 News.
Okay, Steve, thank you. Meanwhile, visitation for the victim, Tim Fletcher, will be tomorrow night from 6 until 8 at O'Brien Chapel Funeral Home in Thomasville. The funeral will be at Pine Hill Baptist Church on Saturday at 11 o'clock.
Mobile, a place we call home. Raise our family.
Damn, man. And that's the dangerous thing people don't understand. That we got people out here killing people with no motive. They just killing random people, you know what I mean? Just from a feeling. And it's not like they, you know, killing tough bad guys. They're taking advantage of the weak. Again, this is from Ms. Don Diva. There's no video here? Or it should be a video here, I think. He's young, man. Look at him, man. His life is gone, man. His life is gone, man. His life is gone. He took that old lady's life. He stabbed the kids. And it's like, come on. It's like little weapons of miniature mass destruction everywhere. And people sitting here harassing people from behind keyboards. I would be ashamed of myself as a grown man or a grown woman if I actually, you know what I mean, entertain that shit every day. I'm telling you right now, it don't get you no money. That shit don't get you no money at all. It just shows that, you know, people are immature and they're not winners. But it's okay. Planet of the fakes. Here goes his picture, Ms. Don Diva. I'm not reading that. I'm not reading this, it's not even. No, I am not. I don't even know what's going on here. I'm not reading that jump ball. I don't know. You hear my voice already? So let's see. I'm going to pull up this next one you got here. That was the 19 indicted. That one right there was the identify. This is some Facebook joint. Uh-oh. I've been trying to stay away from Facebook. It's getting so messy everywhere. Don't y'all know this is like messy everywhere? That's why I'm not playing that messy shit, man. Fuck out of here. Team no friends, man. Alright, so I went to his Facebook. Let's do it, Ms. Don Diva. Oh, man. She just pushed us to the rabbit hole. Let's go to his Facebook. Yeah, Ben, we're in his Facebook. Your man's over here looking like BG from the lips around. From the lips around. Not even lips down or lips up. Lips around looking like BG from Cash Money. I'm waiting to hear a motherfucking Cash Money song right now. Check this dude out. You got BG lips. You got the block on fire. Shout out to y'all, man. I want people to feel good, man. If you don't feel good around me, you know what I mean? Don't be around me. That's how I am. If I don't feel good around you, I'm not going to want to be around you. I'm never going to do nothing to try to make people fail, man. I'm just not used to failures, man. Here goes Facebook, though. BG lips. Your man must have washed his lips before the selfie. Damn. How you care more about your lips than the next man, woman, or child, man? This is what we got to try to prevent, man. We got to start having young people that, you know what I mean? They just proud to be them based on the people before them, y'all. That's what we got to instill in the young people again, like me. My parents forced self-respect in me by what they showed me. They showed me black men with respect. They showed me black women with respect. They showed me the children that black men with respect had with black women with respect. That's why I have a lot of respect for myself, and I project that on others. People also got to realize there's a lot of people out here that don't want to be respected. Because, you know, we got a victim, play victim society. So how can the best way to play victim is if you constantly being disrespected, you know what I mean? So there, this way, it's kind of like a justification for not succeeding. You're actually, you know what I mean, being disrespected every day. How the fuck can you succeed being disrespected every day, right? So, you know, it's just like that. We can't force people to have self-respect, and we can't force people to respect others, you know what I mean? All we could do is just set by example. If I'm not a good example of that, my numbers say so. Let's get into this plan of the fix, real to the 7-pound best. Let this energy transfer to y'all. So this is him right here. Let's see if you got any videos, shall we? Man stabbed a grown woman. You know you really got to be heartless to stab somebody. Shooting is like a clean way of killing. Stabbing is like boots on the ground. Let's see if you got any videos, man. I don't see any videos. A lot of selfies. So, it's one thing we can say, people that take selfies do crimes, right? Yeah, he don't got no videos. Let's see if he got any Kanika Jenkins friends. Nope. Hey, a lot of people don't know. Ohio ain't no joke, man. You crazy? Ohio ain't no joke. People be thinking these places that are not notoriety are jokes. Nah, man, you die in them little places, man. You die in them little places, man. For real, for real. For real, for real. Yeah, numbers don't lie. What up, K? What up, K Chandler? We here chilling. Miss Don Diva, I thank her every morning. But y'all, let's do this right here. It's the man. Oh, I went to his photos. He didn't. Let me see. We winning. He don't really got nothing, you know what I mean? But we can see what he got. You look, he. I just seen something that made me think he was foreign. I'm gonna see if y'all can see it. Yeah, I just seen something that made me think he was foreign. I don't know. I ain't gonna tell y'all what it is. If y'all see it, y'all see it. If y'all don't, y'all don't. All right. Y'all see anything? Yeah, this is the majority. We don't got to see that last pitch if the scroll go out. But here goes these pitches right here, y'all. See, don't y'all notice? I've done a couple of shows with teen murderers, and we go to their Facebooks. Don't y'all notice we see like the same Facebooks? We see these lonely selfies, humble looks, some smiles. Particularly, remember the live I did with the teen dude that was, he wasn't a teen, he probably was like a young man, babysitting his girlfriend's son that got burned with scalding water and the skin fell off. He lied and said the kid peed on himself and he microwaved some water to clean it. His Facebook was like this guy's Facebook. We got to start looking at their Facebooks because, look, he don't got much pictures. He got some artwork that even shows loneliness. Look at that picture of the artwork right here. These are cries for help, y'all. We got to start recognizing that, man. Yo, I had just came from the store, right? And I know, like, I live in a Spanish area. And I told y'all, living in a Spanish area, black, like, women, even black men, they, not even black, but we can say black, even Africans, when they see other black people in non-black areas, they don't even acknowledge us. Word, I'm telling you straight up. I don't really care. I acknowledge them, still smile, whatever, even if they don't. But I was going to the store, right, in the pouring rain. And as I was going to the store, it was raining, whatever, Dominicans out there, and like some black girls was going out there. I didn't hear the beginning of the joke. All I heard was the end of the joke. And the end of the joke was like, because you know it's hard as hell to find a good black man out here. And you just hear the women laughing and like the Dominicans laughing or whatever. I was just going about my business. But that's all that I caught from the conversation. And I just shook my head like, look who's talking. You understand what I'm saying? Y'all walking in the rain with no umbrella. Talking to Dominicans that can't even speak English about the black man who just happened to walk by y'all, like, come on, though. You understand? So I'm just letting people know that, you know, there's people hurting for real, you understand? And based on that hurt, we shouldn't be out here trying to make people feel bad, you know what I mean? I'm not out here. I hope nobody ever thought I was out here to make people feel bad, B. You understand? You know what it make me feel bad? It'd make me feel bad if people were down with me, but they weren't down with me for the truth, but they probably were down with me for making fun purposes. That would make me feel bad, you know, because I never came up here to make fun of anyone. You know? But this is why we got to treat people better, because this illustration tells a lot, man. I don't even think people even understand it. What do y'all get from it? Nah, K Chandler, it doesn't. It does, because, you know, we came from a J4K community, so J4K people watch us. So, yeah, it does have something to do with J4K a little bit. Just because J4K people, it seems like now that Kanique is over, everybody just became these heartless YouTube Vikings. But we got to start being nice to the people. That's the point of it. You only live once. And that young man, he's never getting out of jail again. I don't know if Ohio's a capital punishment state, but I hope it's not. But he's never getting out of jail again, man. And I hope people in the future look up this Facebook. It won't be no post to it. It'll be the picture of a young man that no one ever saw again. And if you see him in prison, he'll probably be an old man, man. That's why people got to be so appreciative to life, because you didn't have to resort to, you know, being put behind bars for the rest of your life, man. Why try to push someone to that? Because you know what happens, what comes around goes around. And I always used to tell people that in the drug game. I used to say, yo, you know, like selling drugs or whatever the case may be. When you sell drugs like that, and I didn't mean to smack like that, but when you sell drugs like that, the karma is more than likely you selling drugs like that. Since you're not on the drugs you sell, guess what happens? The karma will be somebody in your family will be on those drugs. You know? I had a lot of hustlers in, you know, my old area or whatever, that were hustlers, and guess what? The sacrifice to that game was family members became customers. And it's just, I don't know what it is, but you know what it really is? It's based on the same thing that I was saying at the beginning of the live, when I said we gotta be careful what we let the children hear, because it influences them. So if you coming up as the kid of a drug dealer, when your kid goes out and play, the other kids always remind them, yo, your father's a drug dealer. So you may never told your kids you're a drug dealer. You may be hid it from them. But the kids downstairs know you're a drug dealer because they hear their parents say you're a drug dealer. So now when your kid comes out, they treat him like the kid of a drug dealer. And you know what they do to the kids of drug dealers? They get them on drugs. Because that's how you get the drug dealer's money. You get his kid to steal it. He's on drugs. And even if he can't steal the money, he can steal the drugs. And that's the karma about, you know, selling drugs and stuff like that, because you got it around you even when it's not around you. Because think about it. None of us get blamed for selling drugs because we don't sell drugs. Like, people don't see Ms. Dawn Demon and be like, oh, look at that drug dealer. They see her go to work every day and be a mother. They don't see King Ben selling drugs. They see him doing what he does. You understand? So nobody just coming out and like, yo, he's a drug dealer. That's a fact. But guess what? For the drug dealers, when the people do assume he's a drug dealer, guess what? He is a drug dealer. So when somebody lies and say, hey, your father's a drug dealer, guess what? They didn't lie. His father just happened to be a drug dealer. Yeah, I don't think that takes a toll on a child. It does, because as a child, you thinking drugs are bad? You thinking drugs kill? What happens when you find out all the life luxuries you are satisfied with came from that? You may start feeling guilty if you want to be a good person. You may, you know what I mean, develop depression from that shit. I don't try to figure it out. You know what it was with me? Hell no, no drugs, hell no. You know what it was for me? I seen how bad drugs destroyed people, and that shit is scary as a kid, dog. I don't know about y'all, but growing up in the 80s, seeing crackheads and all that shit was like monsters, man. And you never seen people like that in your life. Imagine just being a baby around all people doing good, and then slowly but surely you just start being exposed to more and more and more, and then it's like you just, you know, it's acceptable. Oh, watch out, just stay away from him. You know what I mean? Stay away from her. You know? And this is him right here, man, Jalen. He stabbed 3 people. On the screen, killed the grandmother. Yeah, the guy on the screen killed the grandmother, 3 kids. Yep. Let's go to Michael Madison. And she's not only the grandmother, but she's actually the mother of a serial killer. And she's his grandmother, but he's not a Madison. You know what I mean? So it's ill, but it's kind of what I'm talking about. You don't think people teased him as a child? Like, your uncle killed somebody. Or maybe he went to school and a girl didn't like him. He never could figure out why, but then he figured out why. She heard your uncle killed 3 people or 3 women. You know what that does to a young black man in this day and age? Because we already looked at as killers without killing people. We already looked at as savages without being a savage. So when you got a reputation from a family member doing some fuck-ass shit, it even makes life even harder for you, man. It makes life much harder for you, man. And I wouldn't wish that on anybody. Nonetheless, young black men that already got the odds against them, you know? And I'm not making justification for what he did, but if the grandmother is the mother of a serial killer and you got a teenage boy here that kills her and stabs 2 kids, even though it ain't related, it still gotta be related. They're related. Let's get into this. Let's see who the heck Mike Madison is. Any more pictures here? Oh, man. Let's go back here. The infamous selfies collage. We got to look at this because you never know. This may be the MO for the future serial killers. That's why it's important to look at the Facebook. You know what I mean? And look, like I was just telling y'all, don't y'all notice when we do go to these young teens' Facebook, they all are similar. They don't really be doing no activities. They just got these selfies and these exuberated looks on their faces with some illustrations of what they're expressing. It tells a lot, though. But we're looking at the MO of a serial stabber. He killed somebody, a teen killer. And this is the picture right here. I said he must be foreign. How many of y'all took USA, US of A, USA, UF of A, USA, UF of A? How many of y'all ever took US flag selfies? I never did anything with the flag because I knew as a child the flag was a shield for the system that oppressed my people. And I knew even growing up that this system wasn't made for me. So why would I sit there and serve it in any way? That's the ultimate betrayal to my elders, just to me. And it don't have nothing to do with doing a job or no shit like that. It just got something to do with when it come down to the people or the government, I'm gonna always be with the people, y'all. I don't give a fuck what job I got. You know? And say this YouTube is a job. Don't y'all notice I'm down for the people? I don't care about, you know, chat numbers or even view numbers. I just like to get something that might not get out there, get it out there, man. You know what I mean? Get it out there. And we work together with these. That's what makes me so proud. I got some videos King Ben did today, too. Got me laughing. You know what I mean? But I'm just proud of everybody, man. You know? And like I was saying before, people that don't want to be associated, we don't got to disassociate on bad terms, sneaky terms, anything like that. That's what make me side-eye people. Just to say, like, yo, I'm going to do this, that, and the third. Best of luck to you. Best of luck. Yo, that's what it's about. Because I don't want to see nobody do bad. You crazy? We was the baddest Kanika team on YouTube. You think I want to see anybody? And I don't even care if that's Duke or any of them. You really think I want to see them doing bad? Hell no. I want to see them doing good. You think I did all that stuff with the radio interview to make them look bad? Nah. I did that shit to help them not look bad. Think about it. Ain't no fucking radio interview coming. I did that shit to spare them of that. We don't need to do shit like that. We got real skills. You understand? So even with me doing what I did to them, that shit wasn't for no bad reason. That was like, chill out. Don't y'all know it was in increments? Like, chill, don't do that. Then it went further. Don't do that. Don't do that. Don't, like, and then it just gets out of hand. It's like, sometimes you got to say, like, you just got to let people do what they got to do. You know what I mean? But building together like that, why destroy our credentials by being scammers? Everybody in the KJ sector has been accused of being a scammer. And if you look, it's receipts for scams. Why add yourself to that if you already got a good record and views? I don't want to be a scammer with views. Because guess what? Another scam is coming. Anyway, I lost 37 channels. Never had to scam nobody. Don't need your donations if you don't want to give it. And at the end of the day, remember, I had millions of views before I met anybody or did a live or did a chat. People met me after millions of views. People met me after hundreds of thousands of followers on Facebook. People met me after multiple websites. Don't ever get that shit fucked up, y'all. And it doesn't matter who you are. Don't ever get that fucked up in history. People came in and, you know, helped improve it and learned in the process. And I thank them for that. I will never take that from them. And I hope they did learn things that'll make their lives easier. With that being said, this is the picture that had me thinking he was a foreigner. I never took a USA selfie. Shout out to Keijin too. She's doing so well. Let's see who Michael Madison is. But y'all know if it do get messy, we're prepared for messy. We're so prepared for messy. Once Messi really comes, I actually have a Kanika Jenkins like retreat. I told myself if shit gets messy, I'ma like go on vacation and handle it. I got like a B&B lined up. So like if shit gets messy, I'ma like go on vacation, take the terabyte hard drive, the laptop, and just go to war. You know what I mean? Like go to war. So just let people know I need a vacation. And that's all I'm going to say. I was thinking like the places, Colorado, go to some legalized area, get a B&B for like a week and just air everybody out that try to come at us. Say, oh, that's what it is? Going on vacay. All right, I bet, got you. That. But I don't think it's going to go there because we're not messy. And we're not nobody. We're not nobody. That's it. They waiting for me to be somebody. Like, say we was somebody, 500 in the chat, they were trying to get their clout off that. That's what they were trying to get their clout off. Like, get out of here. Get out of here. So let's see. Mike Madison, serial killer, y'all. His mother just got stabbed up by her grandson. Believe it or not, I knew a guy. I didn't personally know him, but he was, like, locked up. And he killed multiple people. They had him out in the feds, and then they moved him to state prison. Your man was not Diesel. He did, like, 20 years in the feds. Your man was cut up like Bruce Lee. Nobody messed with him. He even thought it was strange that if you looked at him from a distance. So here you go right here, y'all. Mike Madison, man. This is Mike Madison right here, man. And it's like, just for your charges, people don't fuck with you, dog. You in there for, like, killing four men, 5 men and some shit like that? Ain't nobody fucking with you. You in there for killing a lady, a baby, and shit like that? You gonna get fucked with, dog. You have to. People starving everywhere, man. They just looking for a reason to turn them off.
If you manage a team, you have to try Monday.com. Monday.com is a platform to track everything your team is.
Shit, you dumbass. This is Michael Madison. His mother just got stabbed up by that young man we just saw. This is Mike Madison, yo. Yeah, I don't take hell no. I already told you, as men, we shouldn't be photogenic because we got to protect our families. But if we're sitting out there putting these thousands and millions of photos of us and places where we go and all that shit, how the fuck are you gonna protect your family if people coming for you? That's my only thing. I think it's real feminine, man. Look how people were treating me without seeing me, man. And that's the main reason why, like, I said, please, man. I'm not like that. I'm conserved. I'm a conservative. I don't need people's fame. I don't need people's nothing. I'm just here to do what I do. Put out the information. You like it. We laugh together. That's that, man. I don't need to get props for being the king of YouTube. Please, man. People already know, man. I keep this shit one button away. I keep everything one button away. Like, this shit could be gone in a second with one button. That's why I tell people, like, don't value these people's shit. Build your own. Value that. I value my website, man. I don't value these other platforms. That's people's problem. These other platforms are their escape from reality. But it's really enslavement. Look what they're doing on them. And shout out to the people making money. I showed y'all. Your boy Mike Larry make, like, over $10,000 a month. You think I'm gonna be on here being messy from a chat room? I'm not stupid. Told you, my page, $120 a day. Only an idiot wouldn't want to be around somebody making $120 a day off YouTube. I didn't know anybody that was with us that was that rich. That don't need $120 a day. You don't need that? Word? Bet. Oh, yeah, play around. Be a chat rat. Peace. Getting money over here, man.
Yep, that's fine. This is fine. This seems fine. Okay, we're here in East Cleveland's court on case 13-CRA-00985. The City of East Cleveland versus Michael Madison. Could you please stand up, sir? Mr. Madison, I'm going to read to you the nature of the charges against you and summarize each one for you, as well as giving you the potential penalties. I know you've had a chance to speak with counsel. Is that correct, sir?
Yes. All
right. Good night, Barbara.
In the first charge, you're charged with aggravated murder in violation of Ohio Revised Code 2903.01.
Hello,
it states
Brandy.
That on or about the 22nd day of July, you did purposely cause the death of an unidentified female while committing another felony. The offense was committed 1 week to 9 months prior to the finding of the body. That is a Jane Doe murder. The second murder is the same date, on or about the 22nd day of July. Michael Madison did purposely cause the death of an Angela Deskins while committing another felony. The offense was committed 3 weeks or a few weeks prior to the finding of the body. And then there's a third murder charge. On or about the 22nd day of July, Michael Madison did purposely cause the death of an unidentified female while committing another felony. The offense was committed 1 week to 1 month prior to the finding of the body. All of those are felonies of the first degree because they are aggravated murder. They are punishable by a possible death or life in prison and a $100,000 fine. You understand that?
Yeah.
There are also three additional charges of kidnapping. The complaint states that on or about the 19th day of July, Michael Madison did knowingly force, threat, or deception, use of deception, restrain Angela Deskins of her liberty with a purpose to terrorize, inflict serious physical harm, and purposely cause the death of Angela Deskins. This offense was committed weeks prior to finding the body. That is kidnapping. That's a felony of the first degree. There's also a second charge of kidnapping where it states that on the 19th day of July, Michael Madison did knowingly force, threaten, or use deception to restrain a Jane Doe of her liberty with the purpose to terrorize, inflict serious physical harm, and purposely cause the death of that Jane Doe. This offense was committed 1 week to 1 month prior to the finding of a body. And then there's a third charge of kidnapping stating that on or about the 19th day of July, Michael Madison did knowingly force, threaten, or use deception to restrain a Jane Doe of her liberty with the purpose to terrorize, inflict serious physical harm, and purposely cause the death of that Jane Doe. This offense was committed 1 week to 9 months prior to the finding of the body. Those are felonies of the first degree, punishable by up to 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, or 10 years in prison, and up to a $25,000 fine for each one. You understand that?
Yes.
Mr. Madison, you have the right to counsel, and obviously you've had a chance to speak with counsel now. According to the criminal rules in Ohio, if you cannot afford an attorney, we will make sure that one is provided to you at no cost to you. I must also advise you that other than just acknowledging what I've read to you, you need not make any statements, because any statement that you make could be used against you. Also, with this being a felony, your case will not be heard in this particular court. What will happen is you have an automatic right to a preliminary hearing. At that preliminary hearing, the prosecution must prove that an offense was committed and that you're likely the person who committed it. It's not to determine your guilt or innocence. That can take place in this court if that's your desire. And if that is your desire, we will set a date for that particular hearing. But you can also waive that hearing, and that's why we've given you the assistance of counsel to make that decision. Keep in mind, if the prosecution is unable to establish either of the above elements, that an offense was committed and that you're likely the person who committed it, the charges would be dismissed against you. However, the prosecutors may also take this directly to the grand jury. It's also important to know whether or not you waive or establish a probable cause hearing where you are found to be likely the person who committed these crimes. This case will be transferred to the Cuyahoga County court for their further proceedings. You understand that? Because it will not take place here, so you'll go down to Cuyahoga County. And also, it's important to know that because this is a felony, you don't have to enter a plea at this time. The only question that I need to have answered is whether or not you would like to have a preliminary hearing. And we will set a bond for you at this time also. Ms. Ridenour, I understand you are representing the defendant, Mr. Madison, at this time.
Yes, Your Honor.
Has he decided whether or not he's going to have a preliminary hearing?
He'd like to waive his hearing, Your Honor.
Okay. The court will note that the preliminary hearing
waive
has been waived, and because counsel is present, the assumption is that that's been made intelligently and at your own will. At this time, the bond that's going to be set will be $1 million per count. So there are six counts, six charges, so your bond is going to be $6 million. You understand that? If there's no other business before the court, we will conclude this matter, understanding that the preliminary hearing has been waived. What will happen now is you will be transferred to the county as well as this entire case. All right? Thank you. Court is adjourned.
Food is great. Damn, this dude is crazy. Yo, when they said $6 million bail, you see how disappointed he looked? It looked like his lawyer convinced him, hey, if you waive this preliminary hearing, they'll probably give you a low bail. He shouldn't have waived that hearing. You never know what would come out there. That was his probable cause hearing right there. He waived that. He bugging. That man's bugging. He's charged with killing a couple of women. Let's look at that on the news. Let's look at the news version, because that was just too, that was too, like, I don't know. That was too already, like, he looked civilized already. Let's hear it from the day it happened. Hell no. But you never know where you move. Anybody, yo,
we
look at the neighborhood.
Developing news tonight. An 18-year-old is under arrest for stabbing a woman and three children on Cleveland's east side. 62-year-old Diane Madison.
They killed his mother, y'all.
Injuries tonight. Neighbors tell us.
For the people that just started looking, the guy we just showed you was a serial killer, Michael Madison. This story right here is of Michael Madison's mother. A teen just stabbed her to death and two little kids. Check it out while I find something else on Michael Madison. His mother just got stabbed to death.
That Madison is a mother of convicted. We start with developing news tonight.
Here's they are going to be on.
I got this damn box too long. Give me a second. I got to shorten this box. Hey, yo.
We start with developing news tonight. An 18-year-old is under arrest for stabbing a woman and three children on Cleveland's east side. 62-year-old Diane Madison died from her injuries tonight. Neighbors tell us that Madison is a mother of convicted serial killer Michael Madison. Ray Strickland is live on the city's east side with what we have learned so far. Ray.
Hey, how you doing, Lena? And police tell us that the person behind this attack has been, or I should say, is in custody, and he's been identified as 18-year-old Jalen Plummer here in the neighborhood of Chickasaw Avenue. Neighbors tell me Diane Madison never bothered anyone. They are shocked and saddened about what happened not only to her, but to the three kids as well. Now, police also say this happened around 12:15 midnight. They say Plummer went into the kids' rooms, three kids' rooms, two 10-year-old girls and one 12-year-old boy, and stabbed them multiple times while they were sleeping. Fortunately, the girls were able to escape to a neighbor's house and call 911 while the boy was still hiding inside. But when police got there, Madison was pronounced dead at the scene. Now, one neighbor says Madison is the mother of the notorious serial killer Michael Madison. He told us he said a prayer when he first heard the news.
She was a very quiet, peaceful lady, kept to herself, was never any trouble. I mean, she was a nice person as far as I knew. It just makes you wonder, what was he thinking and what was the motive and what was his mindset and why?
East Cleveland police also tell us this is the same house Madison was arrested in back in 2013 when he was convicted for the murders of at least three women. As for the children, Lena, they were transported to Rainbow Children's Hospital.
Bad around.
It appears they are going to
now
be okay.
At least.
Live in Cleveland, Ray Strickland, Channel 3 News.
All right, thanks,
damn,
Ray. We'll
man.
See you back here at 11.
I would start thinking there's something wrong with that house, man, if people getting killed there like that. Shit, man.
It's your last chance to experience Broadway's most epic thrill ride.
Developing story about that we've been following closely for years. The death penalty case against convicted murderer Michael Madison. It's all but over.
Today, a jury recommended he die for killing three East Cleveland women. But the case is not over yet. Derek Waller was in court for the decision. Derek, what happens now?
Well, Lee, actually, it's up to the judge. The judge will have the final decision as to whether Michael Madison goes to prison for the rest of his life or death row.
The families of Michael Madison's victims cried tears of joy moments after jurors returned their decision, the death penalty on every count against him.
Number 9.
Yes.
Number 10.
Yes.
Michael Madison sat emotionless as the jury confirmed their recommendation.
We therefore unanimously find that the sentence of death should be imposed upon the defendant, Michael Madison.
Previously, that same jury found him guilty of killing these three women, Sherelle DeTerry, Angela Deskins, and Shatisha Shealy, in East Cleveland between 2012 and 2013. Prosecutor Tim McGinty said the brutality of their murders, their bodies mutilated and left in trash bags, left the jury with no choice.
If anyone was ever due this sentence, it would be a cold-blooded serial killer like Michael Madison.
Now it's up to Judge McDonald to confirm that death penalty decision. But even if it stands, with a costly appeal and drug manufacturers who are unwilling to make that lethal injection cocktail, Madison could sit in prison for years.
Justice moves slow, way too slow for my satisfaction.
But now handcuffed and hauled away, Madison will never again be a free man. Today's sentence was clearly gratifying to the families of his victims. But as Shatisha Shealy's mom recently told News Channel 5, it's not gratifying enough.
We all know she's never coming back.
And everyone will be back in court next Thursday afternoon at 1:30 for the judge's final sentencing on this, including the family of the victims, who I'm told are expected to make one final statement. Live in Cleveland, Derek Waller, News Channel 5.
Hey, Jason here.
Shut up, Jason. I don't know how people could get so angry at somebody they really, really like, you know what I mean? Want to go through all this court shit. I don't think nothing is worth that shit. I can't see myself like, going to court from prison for one of these dumb motherfuckers or some stranger. That's why I try to prevent just thinking this shit is all right, man. Just thinking doing sporadic, violent, criminal shit is all right. And believe it or not, I grew up in the age of that. And I know people that grew up in that age that had kids that might even think the same thing. Here go his arraignment.
I just heard a short proceeding.
Oh, I'm sorry. Are you feeling well enough to go through a short but important legal proceeding?
Yeah, I'll make it.
Okay, you are appearing in the courtroom by video conference. I understand Mr. Corrigan from the Public Defender's Office is there with you. Is it permissible with you that we conduct your arraignment in this remote video conferencing fashion?
Yes, it is.
Okay, I'll show you waived your physical appearance in the arraignment room today. I also have to briefly go through with you your constitutional rights. This will take a minute. If you have any questions, you'll let us know, okay?
Right.
Well, it is my duty to advise you of your rights and to conduct this arraignment. Both the Constitution of the United States and the state of Ohio guarantee every person charged with certain criminal offense, with certain criminal offenses, certain basic rights. They are as follows. You have a right to know and understand the charges placed against you. You have a right to a public and speedy trial. You have a right to a trial by jury, but you can elect to have your trial conducted with a court judge sitting without a jury. You have a trial. The state of Ohio is the burden of proof. They have to prove guilt beyond a reasonable doubt with evidence. You have a right to meet your accusers face to face and to cross-examine witnesses for the prosecution through your attorney. You have the right to summon or subpoena witnesses in your behalf. You may not be compelled to testify against yourself. You have a right to an attorney.
Thank you for reminding me, Ms. Don Diva. I am about to like my next one.
You will be assessed a $25 fee for an appointed attorney, but you will, of course, still get a lawyer even if you can't afford the $25. You may be ordered to repay the cost of court-appointed counsel in the future. In this arraignment, this includes the setting of a bond. And of course, we'll ask you when you received a copy of your indictment and whether or not you understand.
I see you, Kate Chandler.
There is a requirement that you have 24 hours before you must answer an indictment. So if this morning is less than 24 hours since you received your indictment, you still can elect to skip the 24-hour waiting period and we can conclude your arraignment this morning. And then, of course, finally, we're going to ask you how you wish to plead. Whether you plead guilty or not guilty, we're going to assign a judge to your case. So, Mr. Madison, when did you receive a copy of these two indictments?
Yesterday. So, I believe it was
yesterday. Okay, can we skip the 24-hour waiting period for each of these indictments and go forward with your arraignment today?
Yes, we can.
Can we skip reading the indictments to you and enter a plea of not guilty to each and every charge in both indictments?
Yes, we can.
Okay.
Yes.
Now, in the 576419 case number, you're charged with a single count of failure to provide a notice of an address change. And in that, I'm setting a $25,000 bond. In the 576472 case, in which you're charged with a larger number of offenses, including aggravated murder, we're going to continue the bond set below in the amount of $6 million. Because you are charged with one or more sexually oriented offenses, particularly rape, you are ordered to submit to medical tests required by law. The sheriff will take the necessary steps to cause you to be examined by a physician who shall perform or order the performance of one or more.
Which I remember what I said about the karma. If people heard his grandmother's son murder somebody and he get teased every day or beat up every day by the victim's family, you'll build up some resentment for being born in that family. I'm not saying it's the case. But I'm just giving some scenarios of why he did it or what the motive would have been.
More tests to determine if you are a carrier of the virus that caused.
How you gonna say no, bitch? You don't think just because he murdered women that he wouldn't be bothered by his mother being murdered? Damn, bitch.
Steps will include your detention in custody for a reasonable period to have the AIDS test performed. The results of the test will be communicated in strictest confidence to the court administrator, who will immediately notify the assigned of the test results. Both of these cases are placed on the docket of Judge Nancy R. McDonald. Let me ask you if you have counsel or the money to go get yourself counsel to represent you.
No.
I'll appoint two lawyers to represent you in the 576472 case, since you are entitled to two counsel on aggravated murder charges. In the 576419, I'll appoint a single lawyer to represent you. Judge McDonald will hold the pretrial in this case on August 5th at 9 o'clock. I believe this concludes your arraignment, Mr. Madison. Any questions or difficulties?
No.
Okay, thank you very much. Good day to you.
Hey, did y'all get a chance to share these in the group?
Okay, excuse me, I misspoke about the first court appearance. It's August 6th, Tuesday, this coming Tuesday at 9 o'clock. This concludes our arraignment and our record appearance today. All rise. The court is now adjourned.
You don't even got that same lawyer, y'all. That's some fucked up shit. That black lady lawyer made him waive his preliminary hearing, and now look, she not even his lawyer no more. So young people, learn from this shit, man. Don't be thinking just because somebody advised you or something, it's the right thing to do, man, because he just got jerked out his preliminary hearing by a woman that he's never even going to see again. I want to look for something else. Here goes his ex-girlfriend. I think Ohio is like the number one leading state for mixed children, next to Indiana.
Can your website clone visitors? So every time you get a visit,
girlfriend's testimony, y'all.
Today was the fourth day of testimony murder trial of accused East Cleveland serial killer Michael Madison. And this afternoon, the jury heard from Madison's girlfriend at the time he was arrested in July 2013, Shante Mahone. And Ms. Mahone told the jury about her relationship with Madison, which began in the
All right. I also want y'all to know, the people watching, you see how he made this video? This is how you're supposed to make videos. It's simply him, pictures, and that's it. And you can do this just by reading the article and then having your own interpretation of it. That's it. We don't need videos. We don't need music. We don't need none of that shit. This is it right here.
October before his arrest. And before the deaths of two of the victims in the case. She told the jury that Madison had suffered severe scratches to his face. She described them as deep scratches. Around the time that police believe Madison killed 18-year-old Sherelda Terry. And she said that he had described a fight that had been interrupted by a woman who scratched his face. She told the jury that at the time those answers satisfied her. The jury also saw photographs of Terry's body presented by the Summit County Medical Examiner's Office, as well as the first few minutes of an interrogation that prosecutors say is going to last about 10 hours starting tomorrow morning.
That was it, man. That was it. That was it. Yeah, he had a girlfriend. But you saw how he made that video? That was a great video in under 3 minutes. That was it, please. I've done videos similar to that, just with a picture. Picture and me. And that's what makes you a YouTuber. Not just you on YouTube with an account. Actually creating something out of nothing. There's people out there waiting for my next picture video, man. But yo, look how many views he got. 12,000 views, y'all. 12,000 views for that video. And that's one thing about YouTube. When you do give them your soul, the views are honest. I think he deserves 12,000 for that. Hey, yo, somebody even got a remembering his mother. Let's check out remembering his mother. This ain't gonna be a long live. I'm about to end it. We probably look at like one or two more videos because this is a sad story. They don't got much on Jalen. And the young man, we're gonna play his story again, but the guy on the cover of this live is the actual young man accused of killing serial killer Michael Madison from Ohio's mother. Here go the story of Diane Madison, the remembrance of her. Y'all rocking with the real to the seventh power best, Planet of Fakes, new Umbrella Corp.
Again, Diane Madison was the mother of Michael Madison, but friends don't want that to be what defines her. Today, our Monica Robbins spoke to people who paint a picture of a woman who was a kind friend to many.
Diane was a loving, kind person, and I think sometimes that gets lost.
Ken Wood doesn't want his...
That's messed up that, you know, people get their faces blurred out, but that's the news anyway. But a lot of people, I don't know, that's why I'm not photogenic like that. Because I'm so used to seeing these pictures that they're taking off Facebook to show the Daily Departed. So now when I see pictures on Facebook, it reminds me of dead people. That shit's fucked up, right? Yeah, that shit is crazy because it's subliminal behind subliminals. If they start taking the pictures from Facebook to describe dead people, then when we go on Facebook, we basically looking at what they use to describe dead people. That's some fucked up shit. Back in the days, the families had to give you a photo. Now the news is just taking photos.
His friend remembered as the mother of serial killer Michael Madison.
Almost all of us who worked with her remained friends with her afterward. That's the kind of person she was.
He and Robert Kuntz worked with Diane at the Western Reserve Land Conservancy and stayed in touch with her, even after they left to work for the Boys and Girls Club.
And I just want them to remember her smile and remember how much laughter and joy she brought to people's lives.
She was someone who was compassionate, who cared about her family, who cared about her grandkids, who cared about her kids even when they couldn't reciprocate, maybe.
They were there to listen when she had to deal with the trial and sentencing of her son and watched how she handled the situation.
With courage, facing the problem, not running away from it, not being willing to, you know, not being unwilling to talk about it, and trying to make the next day better than the current day.
Kuntz said she cared for her grandchildren,
exactly,
including Michael's kids, and tried to make their world a better place.
When you're young, you don't realize. You don't want no problems when you get old, man. You just want to, you know, fade out of existence, man. You don't want to get tragically, you know what I mean? Like, who want to live their life just to be attacked when you're the most vulnerable, man? And that's the messed up thing about living in a violent society. People start training themselves with this violence, never get to use it, and just sporadically act out one day, man, on the wrong people. I don't get like that. I get away from motherfuckers. Once people start acting stupid, I just stop fucking with them, yo. I'm not one of those people that feel you have to be in my life at all. Because once I'm doing something, if you're not doing something that's going to have you where I'm going to be, I'm not fucking with you. It's just like that, because, you know, if we all trying to make tomorrow better, we all should be doing our best at doing that, man. You know what I mean? And it ain't even like, you know, any blueprint for that. But we know what's not productive and we know what is productive. We just got to get back into producing for ourselves, man, and just start producing for everybody else. That's my whole thing. Yeah, thanks for that Facebook group, moderators, supporters, you know it.
Remembered as someone who cared deeply for her children, someone who cared passionately about her community.
That's why she worked for companies and organizations that saved land and revitalized historic real estate.
A person of true joy, despite challenges certainly that she faced in her life recently and over the years.
Diane was a country girl. She came from rural Pennsylvania.
That's how Ken will remember her.
She was just fine person. I am a better person for having known her.
Monica Robbins, Channel 3 News.
Damn, man. Yeah, we ain't getting into that yet. One more. Let's see. Oh, did y'all know this is... Look, I said two more. Let's do it. Yo, this is gonna bug you out. Here go. They're gonna read his verdict. We're going to read his verdict, and then, you know, I might show y'all the end of the death sentence, and then I'm going to show you something strange. Not really strange, but I'm going to show you something out of the ordinary. Planet of the Fakes families. See, I always try to inspire people to make money on YouTube, because when you make money on YouTube, do you really care what people say that's not interfering with that or not making money themselves? Remember the analogy I always gave you. If you out on a date and you see a homeless man and that homeless man talking shit to you like, oh, fuck y'all. Y'all ugly. Those shoes are terrible. That meal you ate is shitty. Fuck out of here. That's why you got a shitty home. They're homeless. And this is what they screaming to you. Would you really get mad at them? No, you would feel sorry for them, right? Yes, you feel sorry for them. And that's how we gotta do with people like that. You know what I mean? Feel sorry for them. Because they're wasting their time. They're wasting their energy. They're wasting their existence. And ain't nobody gonna come and create one for them.
This is $10,000.
Seen that?
In my hand right.
Let's fast forward.
Count one, aggravated murder, guilty of Chatisha Shealy. Firearm specification, did not prove beyond a reasonable doubt the defendant had a firearm on or about his person. Specification, sexual motivation, the defendant did commit the offense with the sexual motivation. Course of conduct specification, guilty of purposely killing Chatisha Shealy, Angela Deskins, and or Sherelle DeTerry as charged in count one of the indictment. Felony murder specification, did commit the offense while committing, attempting to commit, or fleeing immediately after committing or attempting to commit kidnapping, and was either the principal offender, or if not the principal offender, committed the aggravated murder with prior calculation design as charged in count one of the indictment. Count two, aggravated murder. Guilty of aggravated murder, purposely causing the death of Chatisha Shealy with respect to kidnapping. Firearm specification, the state did not prove beyond reasonable doubt that there was a firearm on or about his person. Sexual motivation specification, the defendant did commit the offense with a sexual motivation. Course of conduct specification, the defendant is also guilty of purposely killing Chatisha Shealy, Angela H. Deskins, and or Sherelle DeTerry as charged in count two of the indictment. Felony murder, the defendant did commit the offense while committing, attempting, or committing, etc., the offense of kidnapping. Count three, kidnapping, guilty of Chatisha Shealy. Firearm specification, the state did not prove beyond a reasonable doubt the defendant had a firearm. Specification, a sexual motivation specification, that the defendant did commit the offense with the sexual motivation. Count four, aggravated murder, guilty, caused the death of Angela H. Deskins, as alleged in count four.
Gotta feel empathy for him.
The defendant did not, the state did not prove beyond a reasonable doubt the defendant had a firearm. Sexual motivation specification, that the defendant did commit the offense with the sexual motivation. Course of conduct specification, the defendant is also guilty of purposely killing Angela H. Deskins, Chatisha D. Shealy, and or Sherelle DeTerry as charged in count four. Felony murder, answering the affirmative, Michael Madison did commit the offense while committing, attempting to commit, or fleeing, etc., the offense of kidnapping. Count five, aggravated murder, guilty of purposely causing the death of Angela H. Deskins. Firearm specification, the state did not prove beyond reasonable doubt the defendant had a firearm. Sexual motivation specification, that the defendant did commit the offense with the sexual motivation. Course of conduct specification, the defendant is also guilty of purposely killing Angela H. Deskins, Chatisha D. Shealy, and or Sherelle DeTerry as charged in count five. The felony murder specification answered in the affirmative. The defendant, Michael Madison, did commit the offense while in the commission of the kidnapping, etc.
And just for the people that watching, hit that like button, share this where it could be shared. This is Michael Madison, the serial killer. The young man, damn, the picture. picture is messed up. Give me a second. I want to show y'all what the live's about. This young man right here is accused of killing Michael Madison, the man you see in the courtroom, stabbing his mother to death and two children. And I asked, and I guess Kay Chandler asked, Ms. Don Diva asked, do y'all think, or do we think that, you know, it bothered him finding out his mother was stabbed to death? King Ben says he don't believe so. Kay Chandler believes so. I believe so. Whenever you hear somebody in your family you love gets killed, it's going to have to bother you. It don't matter what you do. Like I was saying, you could be a drug dealer, right? But if you hear your crackhead cousin died, that will still bother you. Yeah, even though he was a crackhead, he still was your cousin. That's what I think. That's how I made my reasoning. But you know, everybody's different. We just giving our opinions. Here go the young man, right? Is this him? Put the wrong joint. This is him right here. For real. And damn, I think I messed up. Yeah, I think I messed up. Damn, did I mess up? Nah. Oh, I did mess up. Oh shit. I messed up, but it ain't no biggie. This is the young man right here. A matter of fact, I might as well
the principal offender, or if not the principal offender, committed it with prior calculation and design. Count six, kidnapping, guilty by personally removing Angela H. Deskins. Firearm specification, the state did not prove beyond reasonable doubt the defendant had a firearm. Sexual motivation specification, the defendant did commit the offense with the sexual motivation. Count seven, aggravated murder, guilty of aggravated murder in the death of Sherelle DeTerry. The firearm specification, the state did not prove beyond a reasonable doubt the defendant had a firearm. Sexual motivation, that the defendant is guilty of aggravated murder, and further finding specified the defendant did commit the offense with the sexual motivation. Course of conduct specification, guilty of aggravated murder, and further finding specified the defendant is also guilty of purposely killing Sherelle DeTerry, Shatisha D. Shealy, and or Angela H. Deskins. Felony murder specification, answering the affirmative, the defendant did commit the offense with respect to the kidnapping and was the principal offender, or if not the principal offender, committed the crime with prior calculation and design. Felony murder specification, the defendant did commit the offense while he was attempting to commit rape, and the offender was the principal offender in the aggravated murder, or if not the principal offender, committed the aggravated murder with prior calculation and design. Eight, aggravated murder. Find the defendant, Michael Madison, guilty of aggravated murder, purposely causing the death of Sherelle DeTerry, while committing or attempting to commit kidnapping.
Jason Massacre, you saying that?
The firearm specification is answered in the negative. State failed to prove or did not prove beyond a reasonable doubt the defendant had a firearm. Sexual motivation specification. Answered in the affirmative, the defendant did commit the offense with the sexual motivation. Course of conduct specification, the defendant is guilty of purposely killing Sherelle DeTerry, Shatisha D. Shealy, and or Angela H.
Deskins. He is a serial killer.
felony murder specification. The defendant did commit the offense while attempting to commit the offense of kidnapping and was either the principal offender or, if not the principal offender, acted with prior calculation and design. Felony murder specification, that the defendant did commit the offense while attempting to commit the offense of rape and was either the principal offender in the commission of the aggravated murder or, if not the principal offender, committed the aggravated murder with prior calculation and design. Count 9, kidnapping, and the named victim is Sherelle DeTerry. In the sexual motivation specification, the defendant did commit the offense with the sexual motivation. Count 10, rape. The defendant is guilty. He engaged in sexual conduct with Sherelle DeTerry. Firearm specification. Find the state did not prove beyond reasonable doubt that the defendant had a firearm. Count 12, abuse of a corpse. Guilty of abuse of corpse.
He's sick. He abused a corpse like Darian Vince.
Firearm specification. The state did not prove beyond reasonable doubt the defendant had a firearm.
How many count 13,
abuse of corpse. Guilty of abuse of corpse of Angela H. Destin.
It's nonstop.
Firearm specification. The state did not prove beyond reasonable doubt the defendant had a firearm. Count 14, abuse of corpse. The defendant guilty of abuse of corpse. To wit, Sherelle DeTerry. Firearm specification. The state did not prove beyond reasonable doubt the defendant had a firearm on or about his person or under his control.
Some people recruit, MLM. Some people sell other people's products, affiliates. Some sell gadgets on Facebook, e-com. Some like to play with Google too.
It's not over.
SEO or blogging. We don't do any of that.
Laugh at this. It's not funny, but it's circumstantial. I gotta show y'all one more thing. Who's this up here? Rikers Correction Officer? No. Look, let me show y'all one more thing before we get out of here. Look at this. This is gonna bug y'all out. So, believe it or not, he gets sentenced to death. Listen. Oh, we got two more videos. Sorry, yo. Damn, check this out. All right, so believe it or not, he got the death sentence, We gonna skip that, right? Check this out, y'all, Ms. Dondiva, watch this. He mutilated them, yeah. And someone mutilated his mother, yup. Planner of the fake's families. Not even someone, that's her grandson. Why y'all don't wanna give him grandson credit? Because he did such a horrendous act? That's her grandson, y'all. You giving him the title of someone, that's his grandson. That's his little second cousin. Yeah, that's my second cousin. And that's going to traumatize the little kids. It's going to start a cycle. I'm glad you enjoyed yourself. I enjoyed this story, Queen. Yo, I never knew that Michael Madison was the guy that they rushed. He didn't even get him. We're watching more and more people rush people in courtrooms. They're going to increase the penalty on that. They're going to start giving people years for that. You probably do get years already. If you do get to hit him, you get a high penalty for that. You get the book thrown at you. You're going to commit a crime in front of a judge, a bailiff, everybody? That's going to piss them off. They all got to be witnesses to that, man. That's like extra work. Yeah, he gets attacked by the victim's father. Your boy Mike Madison is kicking at him handcuffed. Like, damn. damn, they had him too protected. He was too protected. Look at the father, yo. Look at the father. This is our video we're going out with. Not really. We're going to watch this. Watch one more video, then come back to this. Look at the father. He's scheming. Look, the prosecutor or whoever that is trying to grab him. Look at the judge's face. Y'all see the judge's face? Yeah, I'm going to start it over. You know how we think. We think alike, y'all. Look at the judge's face. Like the judge gave him permission with her eyes. Like. Yeah, he tried. He tried, man. You know what's pissing me off, man? The person screaming terrorist, man. There's somebody screaming terrorist, man. Am I bugging or am I hearing correctly? Are they saying terrorist, 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 terrorist? If they saying terrorist, black people, they're letting us know our status in their corporate society, man. If this man is screaming terrorists, he's letting us know as black people what we are in this society. Maybe his name is Daryl. Terry. Maybe Terry, yeah. I'm glad. Whew. I'm tired of people calling people terrorists for the most minute things, man. Oh, they saying Terrence. He's saying Terrence. 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 He's saying Terrence. Terrence sounds like terrorists. Terrence sounds like terrorist. Whoa, I feel the adrenaline, man, like for real, man. I feel the parents, but at the same time, I feel his right not to be harmed on the way to do his jail time. He's getting sentenced to death, y'all. Yo, he's getting sentenced to death, y'all. What more y'all want? He getting killed for what he did, man. You just made it worse. You just legal trouble for yourself, bills for your family. You probably get hurt. You could have hurt a bailiff. You got to take that shit into consideration. He could have hurt a bailiff, yo. You trying to hurt this man that's going to get killed by the state so bad you're going to hurt a bailiff. The bailiff ain't even do nothing to you. He could have hurt anybody on that table, man. They don't even care about his sentence no more. You're the newest criminal now, and they're witnesses to it. They don't want that right there. You put everybody in danger. The judge is in danger now because now the men and women that's in uniform to protect the judge, they're all going to this event. The judge is very vulnerable now because if two or three people attack the judge, that's the courtroom. That's why this is really, really dangerous, and they be throwing the book at these people. You may not know it because they not letting us know. They want us to think that this is okay and the right thing to do. But if we ever do research on Terrence, whoever this is, he probably got the book thrown at him. I seen somebody get 90 days just for smiling in the court. They weren't even in the trial. They were in the back bench. Family members of somebody like that was getting locked up. They were smiling. They were smiling. Judge gave them 90 days. The woman took it. She ain't cry, nothing. I'm talking about she came out the benches. Y'all saw that on the live. I showed a live where a woman in the benches was smiling at something that she shouldn't have been smiling at. And the judge was telling the lady, like, yo. You smell like that again, I'm gonna give you 90 days for contempt of court. The family member of somebody. Chick smiled. 90 days. chick went straight with the bailiff, smiling right out the court, took 90 days. Imagine going to the court proceeding of your family member and you wind up getting 90 days. But at the end of the day, your principal was to smile at that moment. And you have every right to smile at that moment. The bad thing about it is they also have a right to charge you to smile. And remember what I told you about charge. Charge is commercial, meaning to take from you, either in service or in property. And you are the property of the corporate name you were raised and trained to become. Let's get into this next one, y'all. And then we out of here. This is the brother of the guy that just attacked Mike Madison. And he's going to tell us why Mike attacked him. I mean, why Terrence attacked Mike.
During the sentencing, you have the families there, and they're pouring out their hearts and saying how they're going to miss their families and what their families meant to him. And he's sitting over there smiling.
A lot of them do be used to that.
Which caused my brother to launch at him. To him, he heard, fuck the daughter, excuse me.
That's okay.
The life of my daughter, the life of my niece, the life of our baby, who we called heaven. Okay, so it was horrible to be that close, to have to breathe his air, to be in the same room with a person that is so horrible and don't even care. He don't care. He was laughing when she gave him the death penalty. It's like, this is your life you're fighting for. This is how you feel about it. But of course it is. He didn't care about the life he got rid of. Sorry, that's
and that was why your brother, you said,
and that's why he was upset. Yeah, he was upset because when he's telling you that he lost his baby girl, that's his baby. Okay, that's his heaven. That's his slice of heaven. He's sitting over there smiling like, yeah. Even when she was speaking, her back, the mom's back was turned. He went like this. It's like enough. Enough, and this has drawn on and on and on and on. How much are we to endure?
So you want to know the number one pickup line of all time?
I understand. And to that man, it was worth it. Somebody say, F your daughter that he killed. I don't think I would be able to control myself either. I think whatever jail time he get, it was worth it to him. To be honest, I'm not here to judge him for attacking Mike. I told people how I felt. I think Mike had the right not to be attacked, though. He already getting killed by the state. Whatever he did in that courtroom, let him do it. You get to go to bed knowing that he got to worry about dying and he got a date. And that was another situation of the homeless people taunting the people that have a home. Mike Madison is homeless. He's going to get killed by the state. These people in his courtroom, yeah, you lost a family member, but you're not going to get killed by the state. He's homeless. You got a home. Who cares what he said? You should have said something back. Because believe it or not, they could have killed him up in there. And why do that to your family? It's hard to be considerate and think about your family as a man these days. We about to get out of here. Shout out to the chat, Ms. Don Diva. I know you feel them. I feel them too, but, you know, we see, this is the thing that about me. I feel the dude that jumped, but I know what he's doing, it could be used against the wrong people. You know what I'm saying? Imagine somebody gets accused of killing somebody, right? And they're innocent, and they get found innocent. But the family of the victim believes he's guilty and charges them in court. You know what I'm saying? We don't want this to be the newest craze. So that's the only way I say, you know what I mean? Even though Mike's guilty, we got to look at it for what it is. He's dying, man. He's homeless. We got homes. That's That's my whole thing. I don't think the guy that did it is wrong, because I come from that life where you got to get it when you could get it too. You know what I mean? But I also know that what's good for the goose ain't always good for the gander, man. And Mike's getting a death penalty. Like, that's enough. I look at it like this. If Mike was clever enough to do something that pissed them off without harming them physically, they should have been more clever to do something. And guess what? Theirs would have had a cherry on top, because they get to go in their car, go out to eat, and get a sundae. Mike is going to a prison cell and got to worry about dying. So Mike won that, believe it or not. Mike won that because they kind of took a loss. They got a family member in jail now after that, and they didn't even get the Mike. Mike actually got to probably kick him in the face a couple of times. Mike probably kicked him in the face a couple of times. Watching this video, we playing in slow-mo. See if Mike gets the kid to kick him in the face.
Not all prostate cancer treatments are the same. Maintain your lifestyle and treat prostate cancer with proton therapy at ProCure. Medicare and FDA approved, it's external beam radiation that precisely targets the tumor and stops, reducing radiation exposure to surrounding healthy tissue by up to 60%, minimizing the risk of side effects during and after treatment. ProCure Proton Therapy Center. Your life, restored.
Really,
learn more at ProcureNJ.com or call 855-3-PROTON.
Look for ops. Man of the Faith, shout out to King Ben, shout out to Kate Chandler, shout out to Ms. Don Diva, shout out to the Kanika Valley, shout out to the Woke Valley, shout out to the Planet of Faith, and shout out to the people that don't gotta be fraudsters, scammers, liars, or sneaky. We here keeping it real. 2020's our year. What y'all got to show us?
We looking for ops. Young niggas letting off sides. They don't give a fuck about the cops. We clutching the mops. Bitch, if you lack at the trap, we taking whatever you got. We catching me drop. They aiming straight at the top. No dissing, we told them to stop. Hop out on this block. Oh, this dick of the Glock. Don't matter, somebody get shot. We looking for ops. Young niggas letting off sides. They don't give a fuck about the cops. We clutching the mops. Bitch, if you lack at the trap, we taking whatever you got. We catching me drop. They aiming straight at the top. No dissing, we told them to stop. Hop out on this block. Oh, this dick of the Glock. Don't matter, somebody get shot. Fuck all the cops, I know they always gon' stop. But the way that I'm living, I'm not. We stopping this block, catch him hop out with the Glock. And put that little bitch in a box. You think he gon' plot, he gotta be out of his top. The stick knock him out of his socks. I'm tryna turn a bitch nigga head hot. Brand new stick came with a red dot. Win that feel, I do this shit for real. Bitch, I'm tryna catch me a kill, don't come where I live. Young nigga slangin' that steel, you play with your life and get killed. Shit get real, no step up to chewin' them pills. And they'll come lay at your grill, up from the hip. Blow off his ribs, hop in the whip, now your mom in tears. All of my niggas get straight to the business. We got the mobs and they come with the stitches. They clear the whole street, we ain't leaving no witness. Hated by many, they say I'm a menace. Won't check in when I come to your city. You and all them bitch niggas gon' get it. This Drake all way more than 20, so when I aim at your head, I won't miss it. We looking for ops, young niggas letting off shots. They don't give a fuck about the cops, we clutching the mops. Bitch, if you lack at the trap, we taking whatever you got. We catching, we drop, they aiming straight at the top. No dissing, we told them to stop, hop out on this block. Oh, this dick of the Glock, don't matter, somebody get shot. We looking for ops, young niggas letting off shots. They don't give a fuck about the cops, we clutching the mops. Bitch, if you lack at the trap, we taking whatever you got. We catching, we drop. They aiming straight at the top. No dissing, we told them to stop. Hop out on this block. Oh, just stick of the Glock. Don't matter, somebody get shot.
We looking for us. We behind 23 by the drop. We spinning the game. Can't stop. Keep talking with the chest. Clip with the hook at the draw. Red, make his heart stop. Fall out and bubble. Sending out them shot. We up new next to the drop. Them niggas be snitching. All of them niggas, I'm bitches. All of them niggas, I'm bitches. All of my niggas, sharp shooters. All of my niggas, go get them. Tip full of steppers. Ain't none that gon' get you. Running this bad. No, this not a rap. My shooter's legendary. Bitch, niggas, I'm beginning.
Hop out on this block. Oh, this dick of the Glock. Oh.
don't matter, somebody get shot. We looking for ops, young niggas letting off shots. They don't give a fuck about the cops, we clutching them off. Bitch, if you lack at the trap, we taking whatever you got. We catching me drop, they aiming straight at your top. No diss when we told them to stop, hop out on this block. Oh, this...
I'm going to the top like a Ferris wheel. I'm a thorough nigga when he does my steel. Southside nigga shot out Wrigley Pills. I'm gonna die like a nigga running in a field. I need that karma. What goes around comes around. Karma, karma, karma. It goes around, it comes around. Do good things, embrace your prime. Life's a watch without no time. Yeah. You don't have to run across the finish line. Karma, karma, karma. What goes around comes around. Karma, 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 karma.
Get it. Remember when I was getting gang? Who nigga thinking hell? Fuck it, I'm still getting gang. But I don't do the same old thing. Yeah, I quit hitting them stains. Now, little nigga.
Y'all know what it is? People want a valuable enemy. See, the thing about trolls, they want somebody they could troll every day. So if you troll people and they keep leaving, eventually you're going to look for the people that never plan on leaving. So that's what you got to realize. There's a lot of lifeless people out there, and us being productive and positive is somehow a life to their pathetic, lifeless souls. So they may try to troll us. Y'all gotta have strong souls. Cause a lot of weak people, they don't have souls. That's why they're so easy to manipulate. And no matter how much abuse they get, they'll still allow to be manipulated. That's fucked up. I'm not an abusive person, but I ain't no pushover either. With that being said, let's continue. Planet of the Fakes, man. Guard your souls.
Want a wife like ISIS, got 1947.
Hi, shout out to you too, Brandy. I be forgetting.
Karma got me feeling blessed. Living struggles off of my chest. Life is a hidden treasure.
Shout out to Hidden Treasures, man. We got Hidden Treasures off of here. We gon' get those motherfuckers.
My dead friend.
Karma
had him at a dead end. We ran why he gang bang. But I did the same thing.
I just had better
love. Yeah. I just stopped turning up. Yeah. He was shot in the club. Yeah. Couldn't run from the slug. Yeah. I need that karma, karma, karma. What goes around comes around. Good things embrace your pride.
Don't worry about nothing, y'all. I got an army out here playing close to the belly and tear shit up. I'm gonna continue to tear shit up.
Karma, karma, what goes around comes around. Karma, 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 karma.
Do it, y'all. Shout out to Keith, shout out to Miss Dog D, Miss Brandy, King Ben, Planet of the Fakes, Brother Court. What?
All depends on the treasure pick. See black and white, no prime conductor. And these moves like a dance instructor. Fly shit, no helicopter. I'm tagged, who are you, nigga?
Don't you get the notion that I'm fucking sleeping? When I bump through the chip, you know fuck is easy. Nigga, what you do? You can start to leave it. When I bump through the chip,
you gon' get the block, yeah.
What up? Rock with the real to the seven power best. Shout out to the chat.
Heat up your summer with Remy Martin 1738. We're back at it for season six of Remy Producers, and we've teamed up with multi-platinum producer Jermaine Dupri. We will be